Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Maths Club, Easy Learning. I am Prof.Dipanjan Kumar. Today I am delivering another important lecture on graph theory, that is complement of a graph. Complement of a graph. This is very important for BCA, B.Tech, M.C.A., B.Sc. Computer Science, M.Sc. Computer Science and others competitive exam throughout India, like NET exam, GATE exam, etc. So, I am 110% sure you guys enjoyed this video. So, keep watching, sharing and commenting on my video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell. So, now let's start. What is complement of a graph? Complement of a graph. Just writing the definition. Definition, complement of a graph, complement of a graph, okay. Let G be a graph, let G be a simple graph, simple graph. Simple graph means no self loop and parallel edges. Earlier I already told what is simple graph. Let G be a graph G bar, a graph G bar, or you can say G to the power C, that is complement of G, is said to be a graph G bar or GC is said to be complement of G, complement of G if G bar has the same number of vertex set as in G, that is G bar having the same number of vertex as in graph G, and the two vertices adjacent in G bar, two vertices adjacent in G bar implies they are not adjacent in G. They are not adjacent in G. Try to understand. This is very important. Let G be a simple graph. Suppose I am just drawing. This is a simple graph. Simple graph means no self loop and parallel edges. This is a graph having no self loop and parallel edges. Suppose this is A, B, C, D. Okay, A, B, C, D is a graph. This is a simple graph. Now, what is G bar? That is G bar, or you can say G to the power C, or G to the power C is obtained from G having same vertex as in G. That means G bar and G having same number of vertex. Just I am drawing the first number of vertex. This is suppose A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Okay. Same number of vertex I told. G bar having same number of vertex as in G. How many vertices G? A, B, C, D. Here also A, B, C, D. Now, another thing is that, this is important, the edge contained in G, not in G bar. That is, suppose AD is an edge in G, so AD should not be edge in G bar. That means A connected to D and A connected to B. So, here I am not taking A connected to D, A connected to B. So, what I am doing here, A is not connected to C, so we have to connect A with C. Okay. Similarly, B is connected to A, B is connected to C. So B is not connected to D. So we are doing B is connected to D. So this is the graph. This is the graph that is complement of G. That means the A is contained in G, not in G bar. That is AD is an edge in G. AD is not an edge in G bar. You see, AB is an edge in G. So AB is not an edge in G bar. Understand? The very easiest method I am just telling here. Don't be confused. Once again, another example I am just giving you. Suppose another example. This is for example, complement of a graph. Very important topic. For example, suppose another example. This is another simple graph, that is G. This is another simple graph. Another simple graph. I'm just drawing. This is B1. This is B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. This is G. Now, what is G bar? That is G bar is equal to, or GC equal to. So, how many vertices? Very easiest method. Just follow me. So, first you have to draw the vertices. How many vertices? B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. This is B1. This is B2, this is B3, this is B4, this is B4, and this is B5. Now start from B1. B1 is connected to B0 to B5. So B2, B5, and B4. So B1 is not connected to B3. So you have to just connect to B3. Okay. B1 is not connected to B3. Okay. Now B2. B2 is connected to B5, B5, B3, and B1. So B2 is not connected to B4 here in G. So we have to connect B2 with B4 here. Now B3. B3 is connected to, you see, B3 is connected to B2 and B4. B2 and B4. So B2, B3 should connect to B1 and B5. 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 Similarly, B4 should connect with B2. B2 already connected. So this is the complement of B. This is the complement of G bar. Now, another thing you will see, if these two join, that is join of G and G bar, it should be a complete graph. It should be a complete graph. Like, this is important thing. G union G bar. G union G bar. This is important topic. G union G bar is a complete graph. But number two, G intersection G bar is a null graph. This is very important thing. These two are very important. That is, if G is a graph, then G bar is the complement of G. Then G union G is a complete graph. Complete graph means every vertex joined with every other vertices. Okay. I'll show another example of this. Okay. So, right. Suppose another example I'm giving here. That is, suppose find the complement. Example I'm taking. Find the complement of the graph like this. This is B1, this is B2, this is B3. This is B1, B2, B3, B4, this is B4, this is B5, this is B6. Okay, this is G. Now, what is G bar? G bar, G bar or G to the power C is equal to G bar. That is, first, what will you do? First, you have to draw all the vertices in G. G and G bar having same number of vertices. So I am just drawing here. This is V1, this is V2, this is V3, this is V4, this is V5, this is V5, this is V6. This is V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. Okay. Now you see V1 is connected to V2. So V1 is connected to V3. So we should not connect V1 and V2 and V1 and V3. So we should connect V1 with V4, V1 with V5, V1 with V6. Because this is the rule. The A is contained in G bar, not in G. Similarly, the A is contained in G, not in G bar. Because here, V1, V2 is in an edge which is in G. So V1, V2 should not at the edge in G bar also. Okay. Similarly, you see V3 is connected to V1 and connected to V5. So V3 should connect with V4, V6 and V2. Okay. Similarly, V5. Now you see V5 connected to V3, V5 connected to V6. So it should connect V4, V1 and V2. Similarly, V6 is connected to V4 and V5. So V6 should connect V2, V1 and V3. So V1 and V3 already connected. Now this. So this is the graph. This is the graph of complement of G. Now join of these two, this is according to this diagram, that is G union G bar, it should be like V1, this is V1, this is V2, this is V3, this is V4, this is V5, this is V6. It should, that means these edges plus these edges, that means all this is a complete graph. This should be complete graph. This connected to every vertex is connected to every other vertex. Every vertex connected to every other vertex. Okay. Similarly, this connected to this, this connected to this, this connected to this, this connected with this, this connected with this, this connected with this. Similarly, this connected with this, this connected with this, this connected with this. So this is a complete graph having all vertex joined to with other vertices. That is, degree of each vertex is equal to n minus 1. How many degree of each vertex equal to n minus 1? N equal to number of vertices. Here 6 vertices are there. So degree of each vertex is equal to 6 minus 1, that is 5. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So degree of each vertex is equal to 5. So this is a complete graph. This is a complete graph. This is actually K5, complete graph. That is K6. It is a complete graph having 6 vertices and how many edges? N minus 1, n into n minus 1 by 2 edges. Okay. Now, G intersection G bar is a null graph. Null graph how? This is V1, this is V3, this is V2, this is V4, this is V5, this is V6. This is V6. So, this is a null graph because this intersection, that is no common in G and G bar. There is no common edge between G and G bar. So it is a null graph. Null graph. I think this is very easiest method I am telling here. You understand very nicely. If you have any problem, you can contact with me by my WhatsApp number and a mail ID is given. So keep watching, sharing and commenting on my video with your friends, with your neighbor. So this completes the complement of a graph. Okay. Thank you very much.